Hello, everybody. This is Mike Ricksecker from Hunter Road Media, and I want to thank you. Why is that? Well, you are currently watching our 300th video on the Hunter Road Media channel. That's right. This is number 300, and it would not be possible at all if it weren't for all of you. From way back in the beginning, and that it goes back years ago on an old channel that I used to run back during the old Ghosts and Legends episodes, the original ones, dating all the way back to then until now with everything that we're doing with the Friday Night Ghost Rides and the Paranormal Roads, everything that Shauna and I are doing, and all of you that come out and watch Edge of the Rabbit Hole with Vanessa and all of our special guests. It's been really fantastic, and it continues to grow. We have a lot more coming out, a lot of things down the road, which I've kind of highlighted in some different videos in recent days. So I'm not going to regurgitate all that. Basically, what is going on with this episode, for lack of a better term, is you're going to get some clips of what we have done over the past 100 episodes, between 200 and 300, plus give you a few snippets of some footage that you haven't seen before that you could say hit the cutting room floor, although we don't really cut film anymore, but stuff that has been previously unreleased. You'll get a chance to see some of that you actually didn't see over the last 100 videos, but could have been a part of it if we had enough room to include all of that. So enjoy, and here's to the next 100 videos.
Can we do this on camera?
Something's gonna eat Shauna while we're doing this.
Upstairs.
That's what I mean.
As soon as you cleared the doorway and I couldn't see you anymore, something over there, it sounded like someone was dragging something down the hall. And okay. It sounded like they made it into the gym and it like skidded across the floor, but I couldn't see anything.
We'll include lots of that in this video. So this is definitely a cool paranormal road, and I do mean paranormal, but there's some old cemeteries down there. The mist, the time that I was there, the mist kind of hung in the night. You go through these little old towns and stuff. That's definitely a paranormal road. So this here is a paranormal road today because we're headed down to a paranormal place. So that makes it a paranormal road, which is most any road, isn't it? Welcome to the Historic Exchange Hotel. Okay, it's a half hour till showtime. I'm still in my work clothes.
Today, pizza. I don't want pizza.
I've already had a whole bunch of crap today because of the way the day worked with work. So we brought in bagels this morning. Because of the way lunch worked, we had a bunch of stuff going on. I didn't have time to like really get a lunch. There was a ice cream social thing that we did at like 1 o'clock because of a project we just finished. So I've had garbage all day. Not that something like Chinese would be any better. So I don't know, we've got Phantom Fireworks. I'm trying to go online, look up like delivery, and they've got stuff on there like Bob Evans. Bob Evans doesn't deliver. Nobody, no, no, nobody. 20 minutes till showtime.
We'll see what we can find. It's a crazy night.
But Enigma Underground's going live. And so we'll see you soon. Well, you'll hear me.
I'm gonna go crazy.
All right, that was Rob Zombie. I had to throw that one in there because that just harkens back to the Matrix Online days. And I have to switch back to where I have the write-ups that Shauna so diligently put together. She is flat. Awesome. I could not have done this at all without her help.
Watch it.
Say hi, Mom.
Hi, Mike.
Hit the chimney. Hit the chimney and came down the chimney,
yeah.
And jumped over and hit the gas line,
yeah.
The stove, and popped a hole in the gas line to the stove and started a fire on the gas line. Not in the stove, but right straight out of the gas line.
Okay, so this guy is named...
Vinny.
In September.
I'm super excited. Mm-hmm.
Should we smile at you, Uncle Mike?
Yeah, smile.
Hey. This is not your channel. I've watched your channel. This is not your channel.
What are you, a fucking Jedi now? This is not your channel.
This is not your channel.
You want to go home and rethink your alcoholism.
We'll check them both out, see what might be going on, see... What kind of Pokemon hang out in cemeteries? No, we're not gonna have Pokemon in cemeteries. But you know what? There's a squirrel over there. Real animals hang out in cemeteries. And when you look at there, there is a Ghastly in my passenger seat. Look, there's a mound and a little red flag. But that's something somebody made. And this, look, you see everything's pushed back. See, look at that, somebody comes through here. Oh, steps. Very cool. And the steps are actually part of the lock system. It's part of the lock system. It's like a jungle out here. Yes. You alright?
Yes.
Okay. What is a haunted road? This to me would be a haunted road.
Oh yeah. For sure.
1,000 years from now, somebody stumbles across that. What the heck they say it was? Maybe it was aliens.
Aliens. Need to find that meme and post it. Aliens.
I'm not saying it was aliens, but it was aliens.
It was aliens.
Apparently he was not buried here.
Wiley and Rebecca, his wife. So does he have two wives?
Rebecca Arland, his wife. Charity Roberts, his wife. He had two wives. Where is he?
He's still alive. That is funny.
He could not possibly be alive. He'd be almost 200 years old. Here's something you don't see too often. We're at a very out-of-the-way cemetery, and you see some work here to preserve one of the headstones. Where they're actually recasting it in plaster. So very interesting. That's the hole where the stone came out of. And there's the stone inside the plaster mold. So very, very cool that some work is being done at a real out-of-the-way cemetery to preserve one of the headstones. 1836, there's a couple over here, 1815, so it's an older cemetery. Going over there, they're doing some wedding photography, go figure that. Oh, we got a couple more over here. And there's a couple more over here that they're trying to preserve. Very, very cool that work like this is being done. A lot of times we go to cemeteries and we see a lot of the headstones that are falling apart, broken in half, tossed off to the side. There's work being done here to preserve these. Yeah, that's kind of cool. Where the stump has grown up over the bar. Found a bunch of kids. Wow. It's not all the time that you get a full family like this, and there may be others that are a part of it, but here we have mother and father born in the 1840s. We have three boys. James, who died at age 6, born in 1872, died in 1881. Joseph, who died when he was 7, born in 1871, died in 1878. And then John, who died as a baby in 1877. But on the other side, you have the two girls. Annie, born 1874, survived long into adulthood, died in 1949. And then Mary Minnelli Converse, married, born 1875, again lived through adulthood, died in 1952. So pretty interesting that the boys perished at a young age, the two girls survived. Another thing that we have going on right now is we've been hearing some thunder in the distance.
It's just dark. You want to venture down to the creepy pit with me?
Well.
Okay, now I heard a little tapping down here. Watch your step. So I made Shauna come down here even though she doesn't like it. You know what? Maybe it's... Here's an idea. Maybe it's specifically with the stairs. We keep coming all the way down here into the boiler room. But we wouldn't from the gym be hearing taps from the boiler room. We heard the dragging on the stairs the one time. So maybe it's just something specific with the stairs.
Do you know what it feels like whenever you're sitting down somewhere and your eyes are closed, or if you're laying in bed at night and someone comes to stand next to you and your eyes are closed so you can't see them?
But you feel their presence.
But you can feel them because the air all of a sudden stops moving because someone is standing there where the air was.
Mm-hmm.
So they're taking up that space.
Welcome to a new type of video from Hunter Road Media. This is Grammar Police. I'm going to use zombies. Why zombies? Because zombies are cool as fuck. Their limbs are falling off. The zombie's limbs. Their. T-H-E-I-R. Good grammar is the difference between let's eat grandpa and let's eat grandpa. Good grammar can save a life.
We are headed to Silicon Central Illinois Conference. What do you think?
I'm excited.
My story starts that we lived right outside of Wabash. There's a small town called Chunktown.
I walked in, I said, hey, Tweety. My wife walked in behind me, she says, hey, Tweety. And we go into the living room, and my father-in-law, the color was just gone from his face. And he said, you remember that dog's been dead for 6 months, right?
Whenever we were walking down the hallway into the lobby area, we could hear footsteps following us.
Immediately, I end up seeing this other dimension type thing where I'm in a blue smoke, kind of flames, and I don't know really what's going on, and I see about eight different figures.
Actually has a death date of February 31st, 1882. Well, no, the other one, you're saying you're getting emotional charge of all the children.
Yeah.
Not even the witch part, it was the children.
Yeah, this one is different. It's a different kind of energy.
Okay, this is kind of creepy. This is like an enclosure from the trees. But you feel it?
It's more than just a lot cooler.
There's the energy here.
I'm not going to be able to set this up right, but with my camera, okay. I saw somebody moving by the on the right hand side of the tree over there. I thought it was Shauna, so I had refrained from taking a picture until she had moved beyond. But then I noticed, no, Shauna was way off over here in that enclosure of stones by that tree over there.
Always snap a picture.
Right.
Snap one if you think it's me, and snap one if you're not sure if it's me, because you could have caught somebody.
Alright, there you go. I am at Iowa 80, which is claimed to be the world's largest truck stop. It's a Travel Centers America truck stop, which my day job, I actually work for them.
The Ministries of the Haunted, and it was
Jamie?
I'm sorry.
Dustin
and John.
Yep.
Okay.
Been here, there's been...
So all the equipment's still here. Oh wow, is that an old cast iron stove?
Yep. There's been known to be... In here was their refrigerator. It actually runs...
About 30 foot down.
To try to keep water cold? I can actually feel it in here.
Yeah,
just walking in, I kind of, you know, I feel it like I'm on my arms, you know, that...
You feel like there's little kids attached to you, going, hey, come here, hey, come here.
Yeah.
All right.
There we go.
I walked right into it. It was right like here. So
Specifically. Right there, yeah.
It's moving.
Yeah, it's moving around.
Hi, I'm Adam Tillery. You may know me from Mike somehow, some way. He's my publisher for my book, Mischievous. And of course, you know Mike of Haunted Road Media.
Well, that randomizing of energy of those frequencies is what I was feeling of the energy in the room.
Yeah, it's really good. Now it's going to red. It's actually, it was actually only into the yellow. Now it's going into the red.
Okay, no, it's hitting the red down there.
It's not mangled.
Nope.
That's
super strong. Yeah. Can we confirm that you're 12 years old?
That's going off.
A lot of new visitors in the boiler room here.
If you made that little drumming sound, can you do it again, please?
Right.
If you understand what I'm asking you.
Sound like it came from.
G-Sadage.
It's making sound.
Assembly for the air filter. I just gotta push that to the side, then I can get in there. So let's get to work. Our finished work, the battery is in place.
We'll continue on this journey safely.
Oh shit, it was the alternator. Well, 2 hours later, more than 2 hours later, we're back on the road.
Hey, Shauna?
Yes?
You want to come here, please? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm getting tingly, like, arms, face.
Mine is right here. Just started tingling back here.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, my head.
Oh, all right, go ahead. Head on up.
It's not, like, really bad, but...
It's strong.
All of a sudden started...
It's strong. I don't know if it's bad or not. It's just strong. Hey.
Diesel, come on.
Diesel, you want to come up here?
Come on, Diesel.
Come on.
Come on, Diesel.
Look him up.
Come on. Come on, let's go.
He's like, forget you. He wants to go down. Where's the book found?
Behind the fireplace.
Behind the fireplace.
Might be in
the... Oh, there we go. Yeah. 1876. The Science of Government.
It's just
sorry
as...
for the motorcycle, but...
It's just as bad over there as it was over here.
Yeah, this is like it was earlier. But it was over there.
Yeah, there was like a dead zone over there. Okay.
He's banging.
It's his tail.
Yeah, but he's like...
Diesel?
Diesel, you okay?
You okay, buddy?
He looks like he wants to cry.
He's okay? He keeps looking that direction. He won't come out of my room.
What's the matter, buddy? Oh,
he's
honey.
Whimpering.
What's the matter?
Hey, buddy?
Can you show us? What is it? Oh, I can feel that.
Okay.
Do you feel that?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Right here. Just okay. Right in this spot. Wow. I think it's following us.
I think it is. Because this is what we were feeling upstairs. And it followed me from that one room to the other upstairs.
Let's see if you feel anything.
Because I'm thinking there's multiple things here now at this point. Because you're experiencing something here. I know I just walked through something there. And Cheyenne, you said that you were feeling something just before I walked out.
Yeah, I walked in that room. I had to lean against the wall.
Yeah.
This segment is a compelling reaction from Diesel the dog. In it, he reacts to something down the hall. We audibly, with our own ears, hear the clicking of what sounds like fingernails from a pet, such as a dog or a cat, which are barely audible in this recording. However, you can see Diesel's reaction to it, our reaction as well, and then Diesel begins to whimper again. Also of note is that the cats have been declawed, so they could not have been the ones to have made the clicking sound.
It's kind of a stopping point right there since it got spooked. The cats? It's kind of a stopping point right there since it got spooked. The cats? It spooked him.
Yeah,
he started whimpering a little bit.
When I shared with Shauna the illustration that Adam had drawn of the boy she called Byron, she got chills because it was exactly the boy she had seen years ago, somebody Adam could have never seen, but somehow captured within his illustration.
Yeah.
Okay, so if we're...
What's going on?
We are right here in the National
Park. Oh, yeah.
Is that good?
excited.
Very excited.
Today, Mike and Shauna proclaim... I did it again. What are you doing? You're proclaiming. proclaim their love and commitment to the world. And we gather here to rejoice with and for them in the new life that they now undertake together.
The first thing that popped out in my head whenever I thought of what to say was that it really... truly is accurate when they say that it only takes one man to show you that none of the rest of them that you've been with are the same. And you have been that for me.
Jay. You know me, so I'm in that store. And it just popped in my head as I was just observing what was there. And so I got a few things. But they all mean something. You get to keep the bag too.
I didn't even tangle it. Look at that, good. Guys. Now present Mike and Shauna.
Thank you all for coming.
Hello, we're back.
Captain Minky. Danny.
Whoever else is in here, see the awesomely cool event that happened today outside.
Yes, it was like a wedding, but it's called a hand fasting. Thank you for letting us use the boat. Don't know when you last had a wedding on here. Thank you.
We're also headed to Helltown.
Okay, well, that was kind of interesting. I ran into some graves that may be ancestors of mine.
We're doing the touristy thing and walking through the town. There's all kinds of people milling about, which is really kind of strange to me considering it's supposed to be sort of a ghost town, right?
This is the lock system. And that's a freaking paranormal as fuck road. Alright, well, before us is the Jate Paper Mill.
On the walk back, I talked to my Uncle Chuck for about half an hour. And he did confirm that, yes, the family did own and operate the paper mill.
You're supposed to be able to get up and beyond the bend there. I mean, I've done it on I found the road on Google. I know they were talking about there were still other houses that they were taking over.
See this? This is crazy shit. This is a cool log cabin. So it's still going on. They're still taking properties. People used to, you know, live down here. They used to raise their children, you know, have their dinner, go to sleep, fuck, whatever.
But when Farron died in battle when she was age 44, Elizabeth's behavior spiraled out of control. Her obsession became sexuality, youth, and power.
Kind of pan around a little bit here. And yeah, it's not good. I'll get a few photographs to include. Kind of sad.
So Ariel looked it up. What'd you find out?
that four juveniles were arrested because they burnt down this building while playing with matches.
And that was
2 years
two
ago.
Years ago?
Yeah.
And that's kind of amazing that it's actually still sitting there just like that from 2 years ago.
Yep.
So, but I'm not going to step in there because it's pretty well burned out. I don't want to get hurt.
It's black. It's very bad.
Yeah, it's pretty bad. So, all right. This is Ariel's first appearance. And she's on some of the old Ghosts and Legends videos. And there's Cameron. Okay, so lesson here is don't go breaking in places and playing with matches. Yeah, that's isn't pretty nice.
Isn't that the normal size of the moon?
No, it's a little bit bigger.
Super moon. Super moon.
Behind me is the Stone Lion Inn, my absolute favorite haunted house I have ever visited. Experiences that I've had include an energy that almost knocked me out, shadows that I've seen, voices I've heard, footsteps. There was the white wisp that I captured after the bureau drawer closed, and even a framed photograph of Lizzie Borden that crashed to the stairs.
There is the Bluebell Saloon. So I'm actually gonna park here.
In the 1800s, this was the only railroad line into the territory. In 1903, the brick structure behind me was built
by Bill Doolin. So he was the leader of the Wild Bunch Gang, and they used to actually frequent the Bluebell Saloon where we had lunch today.
And so they took his body, waxed it up, painted it, and called him the Dummy.
Okay, we can't post this yet, and it's really grainy because it's dark outside, but Vanessa and I are here at the Stone Lion Inn.
My first time here, yay! Have only remote viewed it.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we're going back and forth. It's just my screen is changing and doing different things. So I want to apologize to everybody. Growing pains of trying to live stream. This is the Edge Rabbit Hole, which is a radio show, and we are making an attempt to do our first live. And I did play around with it a little bit last week in the live stream before I left on my trip, and now I'm trying to do this a little bit more professionally.
So welcome to Society of the Haunted's Campsville Grade School Reveal.
Appreciate you making the sound again, but I was in a different place this time. Can you stay in one spot and do that so we can find you? I'd like to talk to you. You alright? What did you feel?
Well, I thought I was going to throw up back there, and then I got a headache, and then I started coming towards this way, and the headache went away.
First and foremost, this was a Native American site.
The dig site is actually right behind the school. I mean, you can, in the playground area.
It was a good idea.
So.
Can you play that whistle for us again? Motorcycle outside.
What happened is not nearly as important as what is going to happen.
One of the reasons I couldn't do the Vlogmas thing was a project that I was working on for Shauna, and I was not going to vlog that. I'll throw up some pictures.
Alright, I gotta straighten that out a little bit. It's kind of tough, actually, because I'm holding this with a rag. I'm in my dad's wood shop,
And I'm trying to, if I could straighten this out. Ah, okay. I'm trying to hold it with a rag. So we're in the final stages. My dad sent a ton to help me put this together. Since he's really the master craftsman. I've done a couple things in the past with him, like years ago, just since I haven't been around. But in any case, we're staining. So I've got a coat on that one that I need to wipe off here in a minute, and then that has drying the coat right now. And so it's like I did keep a record of what I was making for her with some significant help from my father. Been utilizing his wood shop since sometime in November.
Did you see it? It went... I felt a tug on my jacket arm. So Shauna came back, and you want to just go ahead and describe what you started feeling?
I kind of started feeling the place out again and started talking, and not too long after that, it felt like someone just poked me on the elbow, and I was mid-sentence. You know, like I said, I didn't ask for it, and I didn't expect it, but I got a poke.
When I think of it, it's like the end of Matrix Revolutions, and, you know, Neo has, like, the light beams coming out of his mouth and eyes and all that. That's what I feel like. The 10,000 lumens up my ass and out my mouth and eyes. It's insanely bright. So, yeah, knock it off, okay? Outlaw the halogen headlights.
There's Copperhead.
I told Michelle about this. Footsteps we heard while we were down here. She says, I'm a little more skeptical than you. And I said, I know you are, but there was no mistaking these.
Yeah, not at all.
No mistaking these.
Yeah. And we're going to get some footsteps.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I'm Michael. And like he said, he's Copperhead. We come here in peace.
I've got a pair of sticks right here. If you want, you can take hold of the sticks and let me know you're here by crossing them for me.
She died right here.
Right in front of the fireplace?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
So just love to get to know you a little bit, visit a little while, maybe even become friends. Came on.
Good, thank you.
All right, fantastic.
When we began our questioning trying to speak with Lade or Eliza, we received a response that someone may be willing to communicate with us. This included an EVP captured on Copperhead's audio recorder.
Just love to get to know you a little bit, visit a little while, maybe even become friends.
Good, thank you.
All right, fantastic. Just love to get to know you a little bit, visit a little while, maybe even become friends.
My buddy Steve, that I wrote this part
okay,
of
yeah,
my book,
still,
he would come over, floor. He was a local
here's
DJ, the floor. And Denny's Blue Angel,
oh, yeah.
Yep.
And Steve
something
would
the floor.
Come and stay at night. If we use a voice recorder, can you try to tell us what your name is by whispering your name into it? If you're okay with that, can you turn the flashlight on, please? Okay, thank you.
There you go.
I'm going to have Copperhead... Whoa.
I didn't do that.
Well, I was trying to set it up to...
My name is Steve Hummel. I want to welcome you to the Archive of the Afterlife. The archive here is a kind of a vast collection of items that pertain to funerary science, mortuary science, historical items locally and worldwide, and also haunted items.
I suddenly saw that translucent ball of yellow light again, this time whoosh, around Shauna.
Back at the Goldenrod, finally. Goldenrod has been saved, but there's a lot of work to do to restore it. Going to be moved from here. I heard a bump over there. Is that you, Captain Minky?
That's me.
That's you. Hmm. Should I be jealous here?
Why?
It was right up there. If you can believe it. Just, what? 5 months ago or whatever it was? You put a scarf on me because we were freezing.
Cool. What do I want to say?
How long you been doing this?
Years, actually.
Come on up and introduce yourselves to us. Come on up and introduce yourselves to us.
I'm playing some music, Annie. Like to dance when I try to see if Annie is still up here.
In this upcoming clip, some sort of anomaly passes through the viewing area in the direction of Shauna. Is it dust? No other dust was being captured by the camera at that time, and it was moving very quickly. While it's not very bright, making it hard to call it a light anomaly, Shauna is upset just seconds later. We'll let you be the judge as to whether this is dust or the something that was following Shauna.
You know, with Annie, you know, I at least know, you know, that she, you know, had had an experience that would make her sad. You know, but I don't feel like this is her.
Hey guys, welcome to the Goldenrod Showboat. My name's Jake. If you don't know anything about the Goldenrod, it was built back in 1909, designed to survive maybe 10, 15 years at the most. Back in 1909, that's a few years before the Titanic set sail, but we're here tonight, 107 years later, about to investigate.
I pull out the camera and it stops, but Jake, you're a witness.
Yeah, it was going off.
Yeah, it was like flashing wildly right next to the coffee. I guess somebody got excited for coffee and it wasn't me.
It might have been me, but I don't think I can set that
I don't think. Well, touch it. Can you set it off? Nope. It wasn't me, but it was just before I turned it. There it is. Ah, oh, cobwebby feel.
Yeah. We didn't specify though.
Yeah, we did.
Did we?
Yes, I said it
that,
had to be.
That was at Dairy Queen. That was the other one.
The venue doesn't matter.
Dairy Queen nullifies it.
Well, Dairy Queen was when we had the full-blown discussion on the bet.
There is Shauna. Well, she did say earlier that we were married, right?
She did admit that, and now you guys owe me $110.
Oh, there it is again.
Just on the record.
What record?
I heard it.
This is...
That they owe you that much money.
Oh.
Maybe not the 10, but I'm here for the 100.
Maestro. If I were the king of the forest, not king, not duke, not prince, the regal robes of the forest would be satin, not cotton. Thank you very much.
Very nice.
Like a little fluctuation over here in the millimeter to a 0.2. Start dancing, Jake.
Did I just see somebody come in here? That was me. Somebody come in here?
I didn't hear anybody or see anybody, but I
It felt like somebody was kind of like watching. Like
felt like somebody was watching from the door?
Yeah, that's why I was looking up there. Well, then I started here. I didn't see anybody.
Okay, I thought I saw like something quick just kind of dart into there.
Oh!
Did you see it?
Yeah, it was over there. Yeah, you saw that too? Okay, cool. Because I was like, it's not over there. It was a... If it was a twinkle, it was a big one. Yeah.
Yeah.
You guys are picking up the pace. What is going on? Where are you? I mean, that was a pretty good size.
That one was in the air.
Pretty good size orb. Like it was round.
Yeah, it's like head looking around. And that was kind of like what I saw came between you guys earlier. Mm-hmm. But it was a little different.
Come back, please. Where are you at?
Oh, it just went right through here. You are quick.
The idea of the show is to be extremely interactive with you, because this is a show for you guys and to be able to discuss all these different paranormal phenomena.
And we like you people.
Yes, we do. So she says he always calls us names, and later on the audio we heard a man jacking off. And this is the internet. We can say jack off. So yeah.
What?
Yes, you heard me right. You know, it was one of, you know, I guess it was like that. Vanessa's dying. So Shauna has dubbed it an ectogasm.
It's
<There she's... laughs> So yes, very, very invasive to do that to a human from the spirit, of course.
There's a little fence right there, but it's locked.
Okay, there's the first road close. Around, there's the second road closed, and the house was right before it. When I was just here in September, the house was right here.
Yeah, because that's a little bridge I was after. The house was right the freak here. It had a garage.
Stay to the middle.
I don't trust this.
It does get a little deeper. Damn it.
Maybe it'll be the Mike and Shauna morning mug. Well, hey guys, the mug is out. Done drinking that, then done drinking the tea.
I'm done.
Is that what this is?
Yeah. That's a foundation. It goes over here. Great place.
Yeah, 1880.
Knock, 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 and I heard knock, 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 like three knocks.
Over here.
Right here.
Venture into the creepy dungeon.
Oh,
oh wow.
Whoa, 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 whoa. What did I see?
What do you see?
That's not my shadow. How far back does this go?
It goes. It's like a, seems like it might be a mirror image of upstairs, which I think is awesome. That reminds me of As Above, So Below.
Shut up.
Welcome to Ghosty's Morning Mug. And now I'm here on Haunted Road Media as Ghosty, the Haunted Road Media mascot. Ghosty, new merch from Haunted Road Media. So $4.99 plus shipping and handling. Go to hauntedroadmedia.com. Boom, there you go. Ghosty is our new mascot. Shauna and I both appreciate this, and that is the testimony of the older generation. of the senior citizens of the area, because they were the ones that experienced everything. They were the ones that actually lived in that time. You can actually see us refer to this in the Campsville Grade School Reveal. So this helped us a lot in trying to place a building at that site that predated the current grade school. And this is the one that the proceeds go to help the Goldenrod Showboat.
Ghosties going for a car wash. Southbound Cemetery.
Well, while waiting to go to the event in here in a little while, I stumbled across the cemetery. Look at all the flowers, all the little floral arrangements. And I mean, a lot of them are just fakes, sure, but it's really kind of pretty. You know, and here's one. See, now this is, okay, see on the ground here? Okay, what you'll notice from some of our cemetery videos, you'll see Shauna picking these up and then finding a home for them. Yeah, I'll show you. We do have some ghosties here. So, yeah, so ghostie has been very popular tonight.
Hey, Paul, come here a second.
So, this guy here, this is Paul Johnson. He's one of the writers with Haunted Road Media. You guys got to pick up his book, Revelations of the Paranormal Pastor. So,
cool guy.
Finally got a chance to meet him.
Finally.
After 2 years. Okay, so I promised to go live after the show. It's been a while because, well, we were out in the parking lot talking about it, discussing, ranting. And I really have to appreciate Vanessa and her friendship and what she said on her vlog this evening. That's a true friend right there. Again, I want to thank Ro for setting up the watch party. She's absolutely fantastic. I appreciate her. I'm going to say that disappointment is a very light term. I want to make this clear. I am not complaining about getting cut from the show. I completely understand the creative liberty that a show has. It's their show. You know, they can do what they want with it. If they want to cut me out, fine. They cut me out. But the problem I have is that after making that massive trip and that financial sacrifice to go out there for that, somebody should have given a professional courtesy to at least tell me about it.
Bluebell and the Bordello. The historic bar bustles with activity in the pale moonlight. A brown-haired man with a handlebar mustache and a brown derby hat saunters across the room and nods at an attractive brunette on his way to the stairs leading down to the basement.
This is actually a thank you to you guys, because we have hit 250,000 views, a quarter of a million views here on Haunted Road Media. It's a fantastic milestone. Obviously, it's not just me clicking on the video to make sure it works and it uploaded properly. It's, you know, all of you guys, all the support that you have shown over the past couple years, and especially lately, which I sincerely appreciate.
In the lower Illinois Valley stands the remnants of a historic stone house, whose ghostly legend contains one known fact, with many variations of the story. But that one known fact is murder.
All right, so let's wrap it up. Let's give some shout-outs. We've had a lot of people in the chat tonight. So, of course, Shauna, thank you for everything you've been doing in the chat this evening. Love you. Robert White from Australia, thanks for dropping in. And you finally figured out the right time. That's awesome. Fran Molino, Diane Hilbert, thank you for always dropping in. Joanne, thanks for your question. Snaggletooth, it looks like you're getting a lot of your questions answered by Shauna this evening. That's fantastic. Linz, thank you once again for joining us. Andrew, of course, I know you probably really enjoyed all of the Goldenrod conversation. Who else do we have here? Donald Gorton, of course, you did ask some questions. We appreciate that. B3 Airspace, thank you. Who else do we have? B. Davidson, he says he came over from Noreen's channel. That's awesome. We love Noreen. Yeah, a lot of people that watch Marine Show have picked up on this as well, which is awesome. Who else we got? X-Group Home Kid, thank you for dropping in. Of course, Gwen was in. Gwen was in here tonight. Jake Medford dropped in. Wow. All right, Jake. He randomly threw in there, he has a generator for the boat. Yes, you have a generator for the boat. Thanks for dropping in, Jake.
Thank you.
Carrie Parrish, thank you for dropping in as always. Hope you're healing up. And I think that's going to be about it. Oh, yeah, Jarrett Osborne was in as well. And thank you for your feedback. Tammy Sifford, thank you. And Tammy's a great support. And Tammy Heisman was in earlier, too. I remember seeing her. And I think that will about, because I'm just continuing to scroll up. Again, I just want to take a moment to thank you, and, well, what do I always say? Until next time.